Looking for magic cards? Channel Fireball offers a wide selection of magic singles and sealed product. You can now use the promo code LVD at checkout. Alrighty. Okay, I guess we're red-green. This pack is a little bit less exciting. I guess an ogre's still fine. Although we don't have many knights. Could speculate on veteran in case we pivot into red-white. Don't really want to play three colors in an aggro deck. It's fine for kind of the dirty mid-range decks, but aggro decks in Eldraine want to be two colors or even one color if you can pull it off. Best cards here, Reef Soul, Fireborn Knight, so probably to take the knight and we might be red-white knights. And we'll have to give up on Lovestruck Beast. Alright, Barrage is powerful. Also like the Raging Red Cap with Veteran. Silver Flame Ritual can be powerful if you can enable Adamant consistently. I think we gotta take the first Barrage over the first Raging Red Cap. Probably get more Red Caps later. Ooh, wow. So red-white's wide open. Wish I could take all three of these. Shieldbreaker, Tactician, and Barrage are all great. Probably take the Tactician now. And then we're fully committed to red-white. So I've got a pretty nice start. Joust seems great, but so is another Tactician. I think I gotta take Tactician here. Although, hopefully we can pick up more Jousts later. Alright. So, Wolverine, Thrill are both kind of marginally playable in these decks. Weapon Rack can have its moments if we've got the Double Striker, maybe Shepherd to pick it back up. Grange probably not gonna be played if we're gonna be heavy red. So, probably get another Rack later. I'll just take a Thrill for now. I don't hate a Carriage. Raiders is going to be pretty weak in red-whites. So, I mean, 10th pick Dwarves means we might get more Dwarves later. Paladin can definitely have its moments, but we're not going to enable Adamant if we're going to be red-white. Now the Ogre looks a lot better. Hey, we got to Rat Cap. Alright, second pack. It's got some powerful cards in it, sadly not for our deck. So we gotta decide between Fox, Trebuchet, Rat Cap number 2. How many artifacts do we have? No food tokens. Just a Carriage. So it doesn't seem like a great Fox deck just yet. Maybe if I have more Trebuchets, Fox can become better. I think I like first Trebuchet over second Ratcap, especially since Ratcap might just wheel anyway. And then probably just go for the same pick and hope to wheel both Ratcaps. Seems fine. I like Servant more in the monocolor decks, but we definitely want to be red-white for double Tactician and Veteran. Nothing wrong with Jousting Dummy at 2. And now we've got 3 artifacts. If we get a Flutter Fox later, we'll definitely pick it up. Not a fan of Tournament Ground since it doesn't help cast most of our cards we care about. Doesn't help with Adventures, for instance. Doesn't help with an Adamant Searing Barrage. Ooh, nice late Fervent Champion. I mean, this card's not as insane as it is in Constructed, but it's still pretty decent in a deck like this. And there's nothing else I want anyway. We can go turn 1 Fervent Champion, turn 2 Robber of the Rich. Make our opponent double check if they're actually playing limited. There's a lot of cards I like here. Shepherd, Rimrock Knight. Sundering Stroke can kind of win the game, but it's 7 mana in an aggro deck, so it's kind of sketchy. So Shepherd I mentioned, good with Weapon Rack, can also make more tokens with Carriage, can save a creature that's underneath an enchantment, can re-enable Adventures. So Shepherd's got a lot of synergy. Rimrock Knight especially good with First Strike on Fervent Champion, and good with my evasive creatures. I think I'm leaning Shepherd, but they're both great. Can also just re-enable the Trebuchets by replaying a Knight. That's a gift, so yeah, we're definitely in the right color pair here. Squire would also be fine. And we've got too many humans for Ferocity to be good. 4 red mana for dragons, also a bit difficult. But I'll probably take the dragon anyways. Just in case we somehow end up mono-red, but I doubt it. Alright, we wield 1 red cap. So, yeah, we almost have a deck heading into pack 3. What we don't have much of is removal, so a couple burn spells would be nice. So, this is non-human to give trample. I mean, I do need a couple pump spells too. Yeah, maybe. Don't expect to play Bargain, but there's a chance. Alright, so heading into the last pack. Just 1 more Knight. Doesn't seem like the 7 Dwarves are gonna get there. A Rimrock Knight would be a great one. Flutter Fox to give us a bit of evasion. Any good Knight synergies? Yeah, Bargain is pretty good with the Fireborn Knights. So that's maybe still a reason to play it. And Knight of the Keep might also make the final cuts if we just need more knights. Alright, so what did we open? Rimrock Knight versus Guide Mother. Guide Mother also quite good with Fireborn Knight. So which one do we take? Which one do we hope to wield? There's also Scalding Cauldron, which is technically removal, although it's a little clunky. I think I prefer the Rimrock Knights. It's also just quite good with 2 Raging Red Caps, so we've got a ton of Double Strike. Wow, what a pack. So, not a Mad Rider deck, but Fireborn Knights, 3rd Tactician, Trapped in the Tower, since we don't have much removal yet, are all great. Good chance we wield the Fireborn Knight since we wield the other one. So I think I take Tactician, and then the plan's just to tap all the opponent's stuff down and attack instead of using removal. I mean, that's also a valid strategy. And then we'll probably wield the Fireborn Knight. It is double Y to cast Tactician, which isn't the easiest, but we also don't have a ton of adamant incentives. So my deck could be heavy white, despite having more red cards in it. Well, I'll just keep taking Tacticians if they give them to me. Another Trebuchet would also be fine, but if we've got enough evasion, we can just close out the game with our flyers instead of relying on the Trebuchet, which can be a bit slow sometimes. Yeah, our deck's looking good. Could use a few more quality 2-drops. Especially if I cut the dwarves. Lucky Clover. I do have 4 Ardenvale Tacticians, 1 Rimrock Knight, Shepherd. Is that enough to warrant a Lucky Clover? Probably not, but I'm also not taking anything else in this pack. So I'll take it and we'll see. Maybe if I pick up like 2 more Rimrock Knights, I'll play it. What is this? I'll take a dragon. Yeah. I mean, weapon rank would be nice with Shepherd and all the double strikers too. But it's still a 4/3 flyer that steals a creature, so I guess no one's drafting reds or white. We did pass some pretty good multicolor cards and blue cards. I think we passed double into the story. So we're also being cooperative towards our neighbors, but I think we're getting the better deal. Second Resolute Rider we're passing. Might need to play a Cauldron. Yeah, really hoping for a second Rimrock Knight here in the last couple packs. I'll take a Trebuchet. No shortage of 3 mana cards, so Knight of the Keep can definitely be cut. Can still hope to wheel the other Fireborn Knights. Yeah, when we have 4 Tacticians, we don't need as much removal. Huh, is this a Shining Armor deck? Probably not. Take a Barrage. Might not need the Enchanted Carriage. Yeah, don't recall ever casting Shining Armor. Alright, perfect. So, do I cut Ogre now? I think I do. I think I'm down to just play Dwarves as a 2-mana 2-2. So for Clover, yeah, I don't think we have enough adventures for Clover. Since typically tapping 2 creatures down is enough, we don't need to tap down 4 creatures for Tactician to be good. Maybe I'll play Paladin. I've got a lot of these lands, Dwarven Mine and Grange, but I don't think I'm gonna play any of them. So, what are the last cuts? I don't think I need to be greedy with my mana, just because I have all these adventures I can spend my mana on. So 17 is fine. 2 cuts. Probably want 1 barge in when we have double red cap and triple Fireborn Knight. Probably don't need Paladin, because we have 4 drops already. So cuttable cards, carriage, dwarves. Maybe 1 of the 3 mana cards. So between red cap and trebuchet, I guess trebuchets have more diminishing returns than red caps. Like if we draw 3 trebuchets, it's probably worse than drawing 2 trebuchets and 1 knight. So I'll cut 1. Alright, this seems fine. Don't have much removal, but we can just attack and tap stuff down. 1 combo trick with Barge in, another with Rimrock Knights. And various mana sinks with the Fireborn Knight and the Jousting Dummy. And then a mana distribution, more red than white, but I do need double white for Tactician. So I might actually go 9 in favor of white instead of red, because we don't actually need double red all that often. So 9-8 in favor of white seems fine. Yeah, Searing Barrage, Adamant is nice, but I think it's fine even without Adamant in this deck. It's a tap. I think I'll trebuchet first. No, don't do it, opponent. So is this a Rimrock Knight then? I mean, I can't make this attack if they don't have a trick. So, can block the Knight of the Keep. So if they still attack with it, we'll know it's not a Rimrock Knight. Could be a Silver Flame Squire. Ooh, veteran. Yeah, that's a good one. Can just trade my Fireborn for the Youthful Knight. Or I can take it and then next turn barrage the veteran to set up a good block. Can probably still take 7. Well, change of plans, I guess. Now I'm liking play veteran and then just use tactician to tap stuff down and attack for 6. Is my opponent dead? 3 puts him to 7. Yep. All right, missing white mana, but our hand's still decent without white mana for a while. And if we find white mana on turn 2, it's insane. Take a Rimrock Knight. It's interesting whether I cast it or hold it for the combo with Ratcap, because it does just get blocked by the Guide Mother until we play Veteran, but it might still be worth it here. Because I want to play Ratcap on 3. By the time I can play Veteran, the Knight can attack. So, I won't be attacking with Rimrock Knight next turn most likely, but we're still adding to the board. And I've got plenty of ways to spend my mana with Ardenvale Tactician as well. Alright, interesting attack with the Guide Mother. I'm fine trading for the Shambling Suits. I see. Well, Fervent Champion plus Raging Ratcap is also a combo. So this can only steal humans or artifacts. So it can potentially shrink down the Guide Mother. Right, so only got one target. Alright, let's see if my opponent finds another Arcanist Owl. Charm Sleep, pretty good. Opponent passes. So we can do some damage here. Let's see, I can Searing Barrage or use Tactician. If I barrage, I probably want to kill Guide Mother. And then could still decide to attack with my dragon. If I attack with everyone, let's see, my opponent's at 9. Redcap would hit for 4. Put him to 5. Yeah, an attack with all could be reasonable. So opponent falls to 1, and Tactician probably can close out the game. And if they use the Charm Sleep on Dragon, they don't even get the Witching Well back. Yeah, I guess we'll keep a bit of a slower draw. Uh-oh. Definitely gotta kill that as soon as we can. I'm happy my opponent wasn't able to make any tokens in the meantime. Yeah, trying to steal it with the dragon is a little greedy. Probably gets us into trouble. I'm fine playing dragon now, though. And then it's kind of an interesting choice. Kind of like taking the slipper here. No. It's too bad. I kind of pictured the dragon from the Shrek movies. Don't think I need to adventure when you only have the one creature. Get on the board and then leverage our removal to get in some damage. That definitely needs to die. Uh-oh. Sir Kara's bad news. Can even give it haste to start pinging right away. Yeah, we're probably dead to Sir Kara here. So how does this work again? Yes, Sir Kara with the slippers, quite synergistic. Alright, no white mana. And I need 4 mana total to start casting Fireborns. But we are on a draw. So if we draw 2 lands in our first 3 or 4 draws, it's not too bad. This one's borderline. Definitely a mulligan on the play, on the draw. I can be convinced to keep. And then between Redcap and Trebuchet, well, now it's a pretty clear Trebuchet, although is it? Now with Rimrock Knight, the Redcap could attack past Spider. I'll still play the Trebuchet. If we draw land, we also just want to play the Fireborn Knights. So I gotta just pass here, because double blocking adversary with champion and redcap's pretty terrible. This could go poorly if they have a pump spell. Alright, I guess could have been worse. Well, let's see if they replay adversary. So I can attack with Fireborn. pretty happy with the chump. It's not just a chump, it's another runaway. Alright, fine. So I'm gonna attack and probably just play another Fireborn Knight. Would love to get the Trebuchet down as well so we can start pinging. There is an argument for holding the Rimrock Knight to trigger Trebuchet if we don't think the 3-1's gonna do much. But I can always pick it back up with Shepherd to give me access to the pump spell, so that's kinda neat. I've got a chonky Tome Raider. Still lines up poorly against the pump spell. Alright, Bowen's just attacking. Not sure if they're winning this race. But let's find out. Does Fervent Champion attack? Probably not, probably just sending the two Fireborns. Yeah, I could like attack with a Rimrock Knight, a block with Tome Raider, and then I pick it up with Shepherd. But that's also kind of underwhelming. Could barge in the Rimrock Knight, I suppose. Better to only send the knights, I think. And then I'll pump one to get rid of Spider. And then I can still play Trebuchet, I believe. Their play might just be Tree Folk, which isn't too bad for me. Might be able to kill them next turn. Another adventure. Okay. Guess I'll take 7. Also get the pump from Fervent Champion. Yeah, those attacks with Tome Raider were a bit ambitious. Fine hand. My opponent has made their intentions clear. The fact that they're blocking makes it less likely that they have a runaway together in hand. Although they might block regardless. I don't have double white yet for tactician, so I feel like probably ditch one. Sadly, didn't draw another planes. Probably a fine turn for tactician still. And then I can pump with dummy. So your opponent's essentially at 8. Lenora's a good one. A robber of the rich. Yeah, it might be worth an attack with everyone. Opponent eats a robber, takes two, but every point matters when we have trebuchet. Just a land. We get to keep Robert, that's nice. So trebuchet has to do the heavy lifting here and get us across the finish line. Not bad. Double Tomb Raider. So, if I block with both my double strikers, I guess the first strike damage is dealt at the same time. So it'd be a 3-3. Huh, I don't think I get to double block it here. I think what happens is first strike happens, but it happens at the same time, so it's not removing two counters in first strike, only one, so it's going to be a 3-3 by the time regular damage happens, so it would still trade for the 2-3 double strike. We're on the play, missing red mana this time. Yeah, this one's a little bit too sketchy. This is better. So probably bottoming Fireborn Knight, since we're stuck on two. Could make a case for bottoming Ratcap in case we draw two lands, because Fireborn Knight is much more impactful than Ratcap. Nah. Well, this is quite a start. As much as I love the Trebuchet, I think we want to get to Ratcap in play first. If they can't kill Veteran, they're just dead. Because Fervent Champion can also pump Ratcap. And Charm Sleep isn't even a great answer here. I guess they can Charm Sleep the Raging Ratcap. Definitely a situation where the not blocking part of Order of Midnight is incredibly relevant. So there's a Charm Sleep. That's fine. So now do I Trebuchet? Opponent's at 7. Yeah, I guess so. Well, I'm glad I bottomed the Fireborn Knight. This hand is a little on the slow side, but it's probably still a keep. Fervent Champion, you're late. Still play Shepherd here, I think. Can play Hasty Fervent Champion to pump a Raging Ratcap on turn 4. Although against blue there's an argument for holding Shepherd to save a creature from a Charm Sleep or it's so tiny. Alright, we already got 3 damage in, so I feel vindicated. Not loving this triple plane situation when holding double barrage. Uh-oh. Huh. Well, it's a pretty good blocker. Play Mountain in case we can assemble Adamant by next turn. That also works. Although I'm probably better off barraging. Or am I? If I barrage, they do get to sacrifice the egg to gain 3. They could also have a counterspell. I kind of like Tactician. Which they might not counter. If they ever didn't say please. Oof. Well, that's pretty punishing. But maybe now they'll tap out and they don't get to sack the egg. So they can gain their life. I guess they've got other plans. I see. Yeah, maybe shouldn't have attacked with the Fervent Champion there. So this game's not going great, I'm out of gas, and if I draw more planes, that's pretty terrible. At least Mountain is 3 more damage. And then when our deck has 3 more Tacticians, don't really want to trade Shepherd for Sprite, because we might be able to just tap it down instead. Alliance, that's a good one. Yeah, let's see here. They didn't play Fairy, so they might have a Didn't Say Please in hand, I guess. Not too many draw two effects for 3 mana at instant speed. In blue, at least. So might still be able to attack with a red cap. Opponent takes it. Nope. Flashes in second Vandal. Okay. I'll play as a knight. If they can't kill the knights, it can definitely do some damage. Oof. Tomb Raiders, quite good here. Opponent's got a very synergistic blue-red draw 2 deck. There's a Charm Sleep. Yeah, this game looks over. Don't even get to steal something with Robber. That's another draw 2 effect. Although at this point they can also just start activating Alliance itself. Yeah, if Barrage had 3 mountains in play, my opponent's maybe at 3 here. They're definitely within reach, but drew a few too many planes. Tactician could still be good. Plains is the worst draw in our deck. So play the Plains, attack, and see what we get. Probably need to barrage a Vandal. Can't even play the Mountain. Sad times. I guess if they had attacked with everyone, I would have been dead to alliance bumping Vandal. So by waiting, I maybe bought myself an extra turn. Oh wow. Ironcrag Pyromancer too. Yeah, that kind of looks like a block-constructed blue-red deck. And yeah, that's not gonna do it. They can just activate Improbable Alliance to shoot me for three. Yeah, the game was still kind of close. Alright, do you want to go face or do you want to kill Trebuchet and attack for lethal? Alright, we're going face. Alright, nice hand. Probably want a robber on turn two. Do I? Yeah, I mean I don't have to attack with the robber is the thing. And then rat cap into maybe dragon to steal squire. And doing nothing. Mono green so far. Ooh, Innkeeper. Might want to steal Innkeeper. Or do I? Definitely have a lot of options this turn. So if I dragon the squire, they also can't outmuscle to kill the dragon, whereas if I steal Innkeeper, they can outmuscle with squire. So that's one in favor of stealing squire. It also lets me attack with robber. Yeah, I think I'm just stealing squire and attacking with both. And they don't seem to be holding an instant at least. And this is better if they have outmuscle. Five paladin still dies to barrage. Perfect. Yeah, I think my opponent's pretty dead. Alrighty, not the most exciting opening hand here. Triple planes, not the best combo with barrage. And the hand's just kinda low power level if we don't draw pretty well off the top. So this is the type of hand where if you're playing a best of three, you don't know how good the opponent's deck is, you might just keep because it has lands and spells. But we are playing against presumably a pretty good deck from the opponent. And we're on the draw, which makes mulliganing a little bit easier. Although there's always the small chance that we get a hand with only one land or too many lands, and we'll have to mulligan to five, which would be disaster. But I think I gotta take a bit of a risk, and I don't think like a mediocre hand like this is gonna cut it in the finals. Alright, this is a little better. So, Cauldron on 1, Dummy on 2. I do like the combo of Shepherd plus Tactician, so I kind of want to keep both of those. So there's an argument for getting rid of Cauldron. Don't really have a turn 3 play if I don't find a second white source, but I could always tap with Tactician or pump Dummy. So I might get rid of Cauldron here and then leverage Tactician's tap ability as my removal instead. Trebuchet is nice. We'll see if they can pump up Sir Farron. Green-white, so an adventure deck. Can have all sorts of pump spells. Squire, Carver. It's going to be a Pathfinder instead. Yeah, I think we'll just play Trebuchet. And a fox. That's starting to add up. So I might have to tap some creatures down here. Question is, do I play Shepherd? I think I do. And then I can also attack with Dummy. So I'm no longer gonna try and pick up my Tactician with Shepherd, just gonna play it so it can hold off Sir Farron. And then we'll adventure tapping down the flyers. Yeah, opponents got their own Tactician, fair enough. Yeah, it still makes sense to tap down the white creatures. They've got one card in hand, and it is holding priority. Trapped in a tower on Trebuchet. So can't attack or block, activated abilities can be activated, and that's unfortunate. Did pick up another Tactician, so don't have triple whites, but I can attack, pump Dummy, and then tap down the two same creatures again. This is going to be a 3-4, thanks to the Pathfinder, but I don't really want a double Tactician here. Could also play the Tactician that's in exile. I think I'm just smashing, pumping Dummy, and tapping creatures down. Yeah, I guess it's going to be a 4-4 thanks to the banner. So I can send Dummy. I would have to double pump to get past Tactician, but I guess it's worth it. And then I'll pump once, play Tactician. Probably better than tapping creatures down at this point. Keep the last Tactician to maybe get in lethal. Uh-oh, another Tactician. Now I'm just dead. Yeah, 14 damage. Alright, that's too bad. Was a close game. But yeah, the games we lost were potentially lost due to not having the right colors. In this game we wanted more white mana for Tactician, in the other game we wanted more red mana for the Searing Barrage. So that's kind of the problem with these two color aggro decks, is that you still want to try and leverage some of the adamant cards, but if you're in two colors that becomes much more difficult. That's why the monocolor decks in Throne of Eldraine are quite decent for more aggressive decks. Crack some packs. Ooh, what could it be? A mythic wildcard. And we'll do a Zendikar pack for good measure. Alright, sweet. But for now, I want to thank you for watching, hope you enjoyed, and as always, have a nice day. I also want to thank all my patrons for being part of the channel, and you can become a patron yourself today and decide the topic of future videos over at patreon.com/legendvd.